Okay, if you're using Microsoft To-Do to organize your tasks, you can do it with three different levels of tasks. You see on the left, this is what's called my lists. This is the category, if you will. So fitness in particular, you can tell by looking here, has two to-dos, two that aren't completed, because when you look over to the right, cycling was on there. I completed it, I crossed it off. Each of these to-dos, though, can contain steps within them. This particular one doesn't have a step yet. I have one that I did put some steps in, and we'll go look at it. If you go to purchases, even when you're looking at the to-dos, you can see that buying a new laptop has 2 of 5 steps, right? Because buying a new laptop is not an easy process. I made it due tomorrow and a reminder today. So I put in all three of those just so that you can see that it's going to show you that data before you expand new laptop. But if you want to go in and look at it, you can see the steps that are associated with this to-do. You can add another one if you want with the little blue plus. But if you need to add any more information, such as details that belong to one particular step, you can't do that, but you can add a note to the to-do. It'll come down here so you can see it then. But this is the most granular level of activity. It's categorized under purchases. It's a new laptop to-do. And then the step is to decide whether or not I buy it online or actually go to a store. So I hope that was helpful in giving you a look at this relatively new feature, which is to have steps as a third level of organization in Microsoft To-Do. So if you like that tutorial and you want to see more like it, you can subscribe to my channel in the lower right-hand corner. Thanks.